Rounding up a traumatized baby elephant is not an easy job.
Kitu cha kwanza nimesema ndugu akikuja hapa na kujanga akiwa amelia kwa sababu ya kukosa mama anakuja hapa akiwa ana furaha na mtu yoyote kwa sababu anaona ya kwamba binadamu ndiye amesababisha mamake kufa.
Mishak is a highly skilled keeper, an elephant whisperer.
Kitu cha kwanza anakuja hapa akikuangusha, anatuangusha lakini wanga tunafanya juu chini, tumpembeleze, tumpatie maji, tumpatie maziwa, tunafunga blanketi aone kweli ya kwamba hawa si watu wabaya. Ni watu wazuri kwa sababu wananibembeleza.
Baby Cities is only 6 months old. She's still too young to feed herself, and in the wild, she'd already be dead. But she's thrived since she was brought here to the Sheldrick Wildlife Trust at only 7 weeks old.
Actually, they believe she's a poaching victim because we have enough rain down there, lots of food for elephants, water everywhere. And so we can't say that the mother died of hunger or maybe succumbed to the drought.
Amdi used to be afraid of elephants, but after 7 years working here, he now sees them as family, a family that sadly is growing fast.
Banana.
Elephant rescues like this one last year are on the rise due to increased poaching and the ravages of drought. This baby elephant was found next to its dying mother. When a baby elephant is orphaned, the Sheldrick Wildlife Trust is brought in for what can be a dramatic rescue. Often the orphan is still with a herd, but a herd of bull elephants like this one can be more of a danger to the young animal than a help. After the hungry baby is fed milk and restrained, they're brought here to the David Sheldrick Wildlife Trust. It exists thanks to a lifetime of work by David's widow, Dame Daphne Sheldrick.
Well, elephants, of course, are amazing animals, and I've been lucky enough to be in the right place at the right time and to have been able to be taught by the animals themselves just about how wonderful they are.
Yes, yes.
The early days of the Wildlife Trust brought lots of heartache as Daphne struggled to work out how to save her adopted babies.
Daphne?
So they all come in, those little ones, desperate for milk. And so the secret is to get them taking milk just as soon as possible. Because without milk, they get to decline and probably die within 2 or 3 days.
But getting them to take the milk turned out to be only half the battle. Coming up with the right elephant milk formula was far more difficult.
Infants? It took Dame Daphne Sheldrick more than 28 years of trials and errors to come up with a milk formula which will suit the elephant tummy. You know, first of all, she tried with some cow milk, and you know, most of them died.
They came in intermittently, and we tried this and we tried that, and they all died, and then eventually I found that they lived a lot longer on skim milk with no fat. But they just wasted away, so I knew it was a fat problem. So then I went around hunting for a baby formula that has no cow's milk fat. And so that's the secret. They're totally intolerant to the fat of cow's milk. And the nearest thing to the fat in elephant's milk is actually coconut. Jimmy. Once they see the others are comfortable with their keepers and they start taking milk, they recognize the bottle, they understand that's what they need, and elephants communicate with one another. Then, you know, it's all pretty simple. You can actually tame a completely wild baby elephant within a day.
This is my best friend, Kalama. It's my favorite. She knows me very well. Since the first day she came in, you know, when we got about the report of a baby elephant found in Archer's Spot, that's in northern Kenya, I was one of the keepers who went down there to pick her up. And then since that time, we were closer to each other. She likes hugging me. You can see, look at this jealous one here now. That's Tumarin.
Mawenzi.
What these animals seem to want most is affection. Tumarin keeps grabbing my arm and putting my fingers in her mouth to suckle like her mother. And what the keepers spend most of their time doing is just being present with the animals, touching them, making sure they know someone's around. It can actually be very traumatic for the animals if they feel like they've been left alone, if they get disconnected from the herd. You'll hear them bellow and run in your direction, hoping to find the lost animals and lost keepers.
As the elephants grow, the keepers teach them the skills that a mother would teach in the wild. How to have a mud bath to protect from the sun.
Come on, please.
And how to forage for food.
Do we try to teach them at this age how to how to browse? So if they don't reach these higher leaves up there, you can see them trying to stand down there, stretching their trunks, and they can't reach up there. So a keeper, we come close and we help them to pull down for them, or even break for them and bring for them down here. She's a very good student.
Me too. Hello.
This close bond between keeper and orphan is possible in part because the elephants are highly sophisticated creatures.
They have all sorts of attributes we don't have. They communicate with infrasound over distance. They can hear seismic sound through their feet. They have an amazing intuition that is unexplainable. And they have all the emotions of the human as well.
Another lesson that the elephants learn here is how to relate to other animals, because the Sheldrick Trust fosters all kinds of orphans, like this little creature called a tree hyrax that was rescued from a cat and brought to Daphne's daughter.
The girl took the baby hyrax to Angela, who decided to keep her until she grows, and then we'll take her to, or him to, back to the wild, and he'll also continue with his life.
Okay.
A slightly more threatening resident is Malim, the baby black rhino.
Yes, he can be dangerous, but you see, all these animals who come under our care, mostly they know that we are their older family members. So they can be dangerous maybe for new people who come here, but for people like us, he respects us. He knows everything. He knows these are his good friends. These are like his family. So he respects us well.
While they work hard to save individual animals, everyone at the Sheldrick Trust is worried about the decline in biodiversity in Eastern Africa.
We suffered a terrible drought last year, and what you can see in the nursery is a microcosm of what's going on in the bush. We had 33 orphaned elephants come in last year, whereas all the previous years we've been operating, which is 30 plus, we've never had more than 12 or 14.
As the workload grows, the keepers here remain focused on helping each orphaned animal they take into their care.
She's so beaten.
For Abdi, tonight that means sleeping next to Kalama, just like a new mother would.
So Abdi, where are you sleeping tonight?
Yeah, this is my bunker up here.
Let's see, we have there's a mattress.
Always they're up. When they're sleeping, they wake up, they go where you are, to your bed, try to put their tiny trunks on you to see if you are there. That's the most part I like.
The hardest part of Abdi's job comes later, when he has to say goodbye to a healthy grown elephant, ready to go back into the wild.
All of a sudden, the baby has to leave. She has to go. And you have to stay behind. Anyway, it's difficult. It's difficult to let her go, but there's nothing you could do because she has to go and continue with her life.